Welcome back to the Buckeye State Wells. Today we are at Bellevue, Ohio. You will be well fitting to send us the line to Bellevue and Toledo District. Our train will be 267 from Columbus to Chicago, Illinois. I think it works to send us the yard, but I'm not positive just that. It would have a rebuilt GP Lear. As you can see, here comes 18M with a NS leading and the UPAs, and he will be taking the Y to go south towards Virginia. We'll be going on to the Sandusky line after he will be taking this Y. The UP that is trailing second is actually a Thunder Cab, so that's pretty cool. I don't see Thunder Cabs much anymore around our area. Actually, we never have. But it's just cool to see.
CP.
How you know this is 19-
1945.
Me too. That has something that we don't need to do. Well, I have to do a lot.
This is something I don't even see every day. It's the wind in Lake Erie. There's a little bit of a sneak view of the little hole through the fence and the trees. Wind in Lake Erie would somehow be wanting today. Wind in Lake Erie I do not see. Every time I go by Lang Yard in Toledo, I would always see wind in Lake Erie, but they would end up sitting. Well, however, since I was above you, today wind in Lake Erie would be moving. I have not gotten good pictures like this. Here comes a southbound manifest that would finally get to depart after the wind in Lake Erie cleared the switches just north of us. And no dish lights are on, which are kind of weird because I would thought they would have them on. They probably forgot about it, but looks like there's a UPS SD-70M that's trailing behind the two GEs of Norfolk Southern. Here comes a local with just one engine and two cars. I don't know what they were planning on doing with just the one engine and two cars, but either way, it was running. I was a bit confused. Why was this two cars and just one engine? I don't know. It's just weird. Let me know what it is, but I don't know what they could be doing. Here comes a southbound intermodal from Sandusky, Ohio, down towards Virginia or something like that. I don't know where this one's going. Must be Columbus. I think this might be 266. So, with an ACC leading, DNSS and the UP. Here comes a southbound manifest from Lormain Yard. I don't know where this one's going, with a bunch of gongoyas. So there's a few of them, but with just an ace that's leading. I would think it's not long, I can tell you that for sure. right. Here comes 12Q with a UPAC-44 that's leading. Heading towards Moore Main Yard. He will be a pretty long train. Since this will be going pretty slow going into the yard. And also yard track for the yard of Moore Main Yard in Bellevue, Ohio.
Yeah, a signal indication. Oh, it's Ann's comment. Yeah, they just said, they were talking about building like this.
Here comes Wheeling to Lake Erie, going back onto their trackage from the NS. And now they're going back onto the Wheeling to Lake Erie towards Norwalk, Ohio, with 7001 that's leading. Looks like to be anniversary sticker on that lead unit, with a bunch of grand cars. I got a really good shot of it. I'm gonna show you guys in a sec, but after this train was clear, I will tell you guys what the next train is in a bit. Here comes 15E, departing Moraine Yard towards the Fostoria District. I think he's going to go west towards Fort Wayne, but I'm not really sure yet. Somehow, otherwise, he would have 4004 DCAC that would be leading the Black Main, and then the trailing unit would have a SD-70M Batch 2 2770 that will be leading, well, trailing of this manifest behind 4004. Thank you.
south?
That's south. It's going to apparently Fostoria.
Oh.
Yeah, look, he's going to Fostoria. I don't know what direction he's heading.
He's heading west.
West? Thank you.
comes B-45 from Oregon, Ohio to Bellevue, Ohio. He would have an SD-70M-2 Duo 2700 that would be leading of this consist. Put a good horn on it, but the turn unit is 2706. 2706 has a normal ace horn. I don't know what type of horn that lead unit has, but it's pretty good. Thank you. would assume this is a loaded coal train. 778. Not sure where this one's going, but I know he's going to North Carolina. But for Hal Weaven, he would only have 2 engines up front. Well, I will explain that in a minute. You know how I said I would explain it in a minute? Well, here we are now. 3 engines as a main GPU. I don't know if this is like a combining, but it works with NS. Just 5 engines so far now. Jeez, must be a heavy train just to haul all those coal cars for North Carolina. Thank you. Well, there goes our weird GPUs of the Van Coltrane 778. Here comes 303 from Bellevue to Elkhart, Indiana. He would have like 6 engines. 3 of them are normal NS units. But the other 3 are basically two UPs and 1 BNSF unit. The BNSF would be a 0, the second UP would be a GE, and then the other one would be 70M. Alright, now we're in Fremont, Ohio, which would be the end for the day. Never shot this type of scenery before in Fremont, but now I really have. This is the Toledo and Bellevue District, with 303 coming up around the corner, and now he will be bound for Elkhart. With still no ditch lights or any lights are on still. That will be the second train without any lights on. Which is kinda weird, but not gonna question that. But until Fremont, Ohio, this will be the last train of the day. We would chase it, like, further west, but I would get informed that we would have bad storms, including tornadoes and stuff. Luckily, we did not get any tornadoes in our hometown. Well, close to there, but it didn't hit the house. But next time, I'll be either seeing you guys in Michigan or State, or Buckeye State Wells, which we are in right now.
Wait.